I'll show you one more time how the stuff with the uranium works. First, the uranium ore is mined. Then, the uranium is extracted and the fuel rods are created. Then, the uranium is split. What remains are countless burned fuel rods.
And what happens to them?
For several years, they are cooled down in special tanks somewhere on the grounds of the nuclear power plants. In the reprocessing plants, reusable uranium and plutonium are then extracted from the cooled-down fuel rods. The rest, unusable, highly radioactive nuclear waste, is then temporarily stored in steel tanks. However, these temporary storage facilities are not enough protection against external influences like earthquakes, plane crashes, or bombardment. That's why it's important to transfer the waste into a safer final storage depot as soon as possible.
And where is the final storage depot?
For the highly radioactive waste, there isn't anything like that yet.
There are more than 400 reactors in use and no final storage depot? For how long is nuclear waste radioactive?
The nuclear industry likes to say only thousands of years. Some components of nuclear waste, however, radiate for several million years.
That sounds like a long time.
Yes, that is a very long time. In all these years, the people won't know who they inherited all that waste from.
So, Sophie, uranium does not grow back and renew itself, and using it causes radioactive toxic waste. Then why do they say nuclear power is clean?
Because carbon dioxide emissions of nuclear power plants is rather low. However, under close consideration, a lot of carbon dioxide is caused along the way from uranium mining to waste disposal. And uranium ore is not infinitely available and not a renewable energy carrier. And atomic waste will burden the environment and many generations to come. Only the use of sun, wind, water, and biomass can be accomplished in a truly sustainable way.
So nuclear energy is not sustainable?
Not at all. Nonetheless, the term sustainable is often given to nuclear energy. It is often wrongly disguised as sustainable energy. Come with me. I'll show you something. Do you see the blackbird's nest over there?
Of course.
The cuckoo has tricked the blackbird and laid an egg into its nest. The blackbird thinks it is its own egg and breeds it. That's how the cuckoo survives.
Right. So?
The nuclear industry does the same as the cuckoo. It tricks us and claims that nuclear energy is sustainable and clean. That helps the nuclear industry to survive.
Haha! So nuclear energy is the cuckoo in the socket.
If you want, yes. Obviously, the young cuckoo is very hungry and a lot less food is left over for the blackbird chicks.
And the nuclear industry is also very hungry. It devours a lot of money, which should rather be invested in sustainable energy projects. I get it now. Nuclear energy is truly not a climate rescuer. Why do humans try to solve their energy problems in the most complicated way when they actually already know better?
You're talking about renewable energies?
Yeah, and about saving energy.
Not to forget more efficient use of energy.
Hey, I mean, can you show me how a solar panel works?
Let's take one thing at a time. Have I already told you...